In many ways, I think of qualities like compassion as very similar to language. We all come into the world with an innate capacity for language. But in order for language to emerge, it requires that we be embedded within a linguistic community, a community of language speakers. We need that input, that environmental input for this seed, which is the capacity for language to actually become expressed. And I think compassion is very similar. We are all born, I think, with an innate capacity to express compassion. But I think we need to nurture those seeds by being in the presence of compassionate others in order for that seed to actually flower. And the evidence of the sort that I showed clearly indicates that if given a preference, very young infants prefer a generous or a compassionate other compared to an individual who is destructive or unhelpful. And so it doesn't mean that those characteristics can't be trained if we're in a toxic or negative environment, but it suggests that there is an innate preference from the start. However, that preference, in order to be expressed, requires the right kind of support in the environment.
These findings on young infants, of course, also indicate that already before a lot of education has taken place and a lot of thinking and reasoning takes place, there are these preferences for certain outcomes, which already hints at some biological background to it. And I think what has happened in the last century or centuries is a mixing of our view of nature with some ideology that states that competition is good and competition is fine and we should all hit each other over the head and that will be fine because that's how nature operates. Now, if you want to look for competition and aggression, you will find plenty of it in nature. I mean, it's really not absent. There's an enormous amount of competition going on. But what has been forgotten in that whole scheme is that many animals, including humans, but also, let's say, elephants, dolphins, primates, they live in groups. And they live in groups for a reason. They live in groups because they cannot survive alone. And actually, a primate who lives alone does very poorly in terms of survival. And so, since they live in groups, they need to compromise. If you live in groups, you need to get along. You need to reconcile after fights. You have your cooperation partners. You cannot kill them, because if you kill them, you lose your cooperation partners. And so if you depend on group life, it constrains very much what you can do, and you need to start caring about others. And I think empathy, is for mammals at least, is one mechanism that we do that. And so I think biology has gotten mixed up with some very bad ideology, which has resulted in the fact that we very one-sidedly emphasize the competition part and neglected the cooperation and empathy part of animal nature, because it's clearly there if you look for it.
Great, thank you.